Hi, my name is Yusuf and I have high blood pressure. I experimented with taking B vitamins to bring it down. I experimented with vitamins B12 and vitamin B9, otherwise known as folate. And I took these two vitamins both separately and in combination. Unfortunately, taking these vitamins increased my blood pressure. And last week it shot up to 212. Over 111, and that was just before I had to go out to work, which left me in a quandary as to whether to go to work or go to the hospital. Fortunately, nothing happened. I went to work and I survived, but I did do more research, and I discovered that by adding vitamin B6 to the mix, in other words, taking vitamins B6, B9, and B12 in combination in high doses, and then doing some aerobic exercise afterwards will bring the high blood pressure down. I tried that and it did work over these past few days. My blood pressure has come down somewhat. I thought this was an important discovery, so I made this video hoping it might help others. And I'll be updating this video as my experiments progress. So thanks for watching and here's my video.
How to lower blood pressure naturally using B vitamins. Here's a possible way of lowering high BP using three specific B vitamins, vitamins B6, B9, and B12. After you take them, go and exercise. Aerobic exercise is preferred, such as a brisk half-hour walk in the park. Exercising with the B vitamins high in your bloodstream may accelerate the therapeutic effect and make them work better than had you remained sedentary. Then, over the next few days, watch your BP. It may well fall, and there's a time lag of a day or two for BP to fall. And if it does, it means you don't need to do this every day. You may need this combination of B vitamins and exercise only once every few days, and not every day. This protocol worked for me. Here's exactly what I took. Vitamin B6, 100 milligrams of pyridoxine hydrochloride. Vitamin B9, otherwise known as folate or folic acid, 800 micrograms of 5-methyltetrahydrofolate, otherwise known as 5-MTHF. Vitamin B12, 1,000 micrograms of methylcobalamin, otherwise known as methyl B12. Notice I've given the form of the B vitamins I took. B vitamins come in different forms, and some may be more effective than others. For example, for vitamin B12, methylcobalamin may be better absorbed and retained than its sister form, cyanocobalamin. So B12 may not be B12, if you get what I mean. And the form of B9, called 5-MTHF, is said to be more bioactive than folic acid, the most common form of B9. The doses I mentioned, by the way, are regarded as safe. They're way above the RDAs. In fact, they are what are called pharmaceutical doses. Take these three B vitamins together. That's important. Taking them separately may cause BP to rise. That's because all three work together like cogs in the body's metabolic machine. If one cog isn't turning, then the whole metabolic machinery becomes distorted, and it may backfire, causing BP to rise. So is there any scientific evidence for all of this? That is, apart from my own personal experience. Yes, there is. It was reported in 1943 that a vitamin B2 deficiency can be caused by a lack of balance in vitamin intake, even when the vitamin B2 intake is relatively high, which suggests an excess of one B vitamin can cause another to be deficient, even if its intake is sufficient. More importantly, a 1995 study from the Department of Physiology at a Turkish university found vitamin B6, quote, significantly reduced systolic and diastolic blood pressure, end quote. And vitamins B6, B9, and B12 were used in combination in the Swiss Heart study with good effect. So there is a scientific basis for all of this. Just a word of caution. This protocol may cause blood sugar levels to rise, so monitor your glucose levels if you're prone to high sugar levels. If they do rise, give it a break. This protocol may also worsen existing kidney disease in diabetics. See the link to the PDF in the description below this video. A reliable source of B vitamins can also be found in the link below this video. I've used the recommended supplier iHerb since 1999 and found them consistently reliable. and they're also recommended by ConsumerLabs.com, an independent tester of nutritional supplements. Having uncontrolled high blood pressure can be a nightmare. There but for the grace of God go I. Having been there and back, I made this video just in case it helps others. If you try this protocol, please comment below on whether it worked for you or not, so we can all learn from your experience and advance the science. By the way, I've been diagnosed with the metabolic syndrome and have elevated homocysteine, and I'm 58 years old. Finally, I am not a doctor. This video is not medical advice. If you have high blood pressure, please consult a qualified medical practitioner. Long-term high blood pressure is a serious medical issue. Thanks for watching. Wishing you all the best for your health. Cheers.